What's up? We are Taking Back Sunday, and welcome to our making the video for a song we have called Liar. It takes one to know one.
What's up? I'm Fred. I play the guitar and sing.
Hi, I'm Ed, and I play guitar.
I'm Adam. I handle the vocal duties.
I'm Mark. I play the drums.
And I'm Matt, and I play lead bass guitar.
Lost already. Been here for 6 minutes.
Here's what I was looking for.
Pre-video yoga.
I bleached my hair blonde and it's been blonde for a couple weeks now. But for the video, since they're gonna have all these, it's gonna be black and white and this is gonna have a lot of digital animation stuff. My hair can't be blonde because it blends with the natural tones of my face and, you know, they can't have that. I'm ready for the video. This is all I'll be consuming all day. 2 bottles of water, 1 banana, 1 emergency. I will eat my own sidekick, and I will then wash it down with my own cell phone. Strong like bull. I'm an addict for dramatics.
I confuse the triple love. I don't really think I had more fun.
You know, being blonde, I had the same amount of fun.
Had to actually film things in these clothes, which were like either red or blue.
And yeah.
These are the colors that contrast the most with the green screen, which is the green wall behind us.
The green screen, ladies and gentlemen. Here it is.
Whoa, look at this thing. I thought Fred looked like a Disney character.
Yeah, like
still
no, yeah.
Do, baby.
No, but you don't have the blue.
Yeah, the blue really sets it off.
Look at this guy. That's the Fred I've always known.
Oh man, you look great.
Fred, thank you.
You could look like you work at like the North Pole place at the mall.
Fred could do that right now.
Yeah.
Ho, ho, ho!
All right, next question.
So the director for our video is a nice, nice man named
Tony.
Tony Petrosian.
Hello.
What's up?
How's it going?
How are you, man?
Good, man. How are you?
Ready?
Yeah, man.
No, you're not. Not yet.
And not close.
The contrast between the hair and his face is what's the most important thing. That's why blonde was going to be a little bit of a pain.
Yeah.
Because it was going to just... blend.
You don't like
head.
Blondes, man. Whatever. Fine.
Exactly. All right, I'll see you in a second.
Cool. Kind of like being in a doctor's office. Like, you know how, like, the doctor will come in and, like, say, hey, shoot, but then he'll leave. And you'll be like, but wait, I still, you know, still know what's going on. That's kind of what that's like.
Adam's getting blown. Dried. Sorry, I just couldn't resist it. I couldn't resist.
Sit here.
It's been a long day and it's still in the AM hours. Hence the sort of losing our minds. We haven't really done anything yet, but I'm having a great time.
No, man, we woke up this morning.
We did wake up.
Which is a feat in itself.
This is the longest conversation I've ever had while sitting on another man's lap.
Sitting.
Yeah. Still going. We could get a little counter right over here for how long I've been here.
Like 4 days now. Yeah. Man, my hair feels so silky smooth.
On that note.
Hi, Hi, I'm Bryn Dixie. I'm doing makeup for the Taking Back Sunday video. We're doing a lot of black and white green screen, so we're doing a little more high contrast, a little more contour than usual. We're running a little bit behind right now.
Basically, the whole day is on hold for Adam's hair. And a couple of other small details of cameras and lights and filming and sets and green screen and stuff. But basically, we're waiting for Adam's hair to be done. Everybody last night was busting my chops about the fact that there's a model in the video. How quickly I'm gonna be on her, all over. So I decided today that I'm not talking to her. I'm not talking to her once, just to prove them wrong. Because they all think they know me, and they don't. You know me, though. We're friends. Those guys, not friends.
They had to hem my pants.
Fargo mock that again?
Good, man. How do you feel?
Good, good. But I think I'm going to go upstairs and put some pants on. Do you want to help?
Yeah. I feel pretty close to you, so.
Yeah.
Seriously, though, folks, thanks for coming tonight. We'd like to welcome you all to the filming of the Taking Back Sunday Liar It Takes One to Know One video. We're going to begin in just a little bit, so sit tight and enjoy the ride. Thank you.
The concept is that somebody is hooked up to a polygraph machine taking a lie detector test, and there's an interrogation going on. The lines which the polygraph machine are drawing begin to come to life.
Things are going to happen with the lines and us performing. It's going to start to be created by the lines of the polygraph machine.
You know, it's like a polygraph test, and the, you know, it's going to be up and down, and dude, I don't know, I suck at this.
We're just about to shoot the final reveal, which tells us that it's Adam in the chair.
And action?
No, it's exactly what happened.
This is looking like a bit of the video that's going to be sort of after the song is finished, wrapping up the storyline, sort of trying to figure out Adam's lies.
We're here in the white space, which we just finished shooting, and we got all the polygraph stuff that we need, and Adam strapped to the chair, and now we're going to the green room, and we're going to do some performance. 2020 surgery. Well,
2020 surgery for Jesus. Hey, Keith, what's up?
Bam!
White.
Apparently the dude was super concerned about this base. He's going to sell it afterwards, I guess, so just
don't belt buckle. For some reason, the strap came off in the middle of shooting. I think I felt a little awkward about it because the music was still playing and nobody yelled cut, so I'm sitting there holding the bass with no strap. And for some reason, the first thing that occurred to me was to throw the bass. I just wanna break you down so badly. We'll let you bump on everything you say. That was accident number one. That was about 2.5 minutes into shooting.
I broke it.
It was a little bit of a bumpy start.
I couldn't think of how to recover, so I just figured I'd throw it.
And I bought a bass inadvertently.
My strap broke. And I said, it's all right, first verse was good anyway. And then we started second verse, and it broke like in half.
Who makes these straps?
It has like a swagger to it that is unusual for us to do, and I think that's why we're so interested in going for it.
Also, in the bridge, is the first key change featured in a Taking Back Sunday song ever. Go us! Woo!
We got that idea from Living on a Prayer, Bon Jovi, of course.
Yeah, duh, where else would we get the idea? I think the funniest thing I had to do was they were like, okay, you're being chased by a giant spider and you're running away from it and you're scared for your life. But the thing is, couldn't actually run. I had to run in place. I don't know if you've ever ran in place and, you know, tried to...
From a pretend giant spider.
Yeah, and tried to, like, keep your dignity about it, but it's not an easy task. I'm an addict for dramatics. I was on my back, and I was on these, like, apple boxes, and they had these fans on me. But at first, the one fan wasn't creating enough wind to blow my hair. So I suggested they bring in a hairdryer, kind of joking. Nonetheless, they brought in a hairdryer, and it was like... And it didn't work, so they brought in this other super fan, and my hair was going everywhere. It's kind of my Bon Jovi moment again. I had to hang upside down from this thing, which was pretty cool because I like it.
This is the first video we've ever had that had live animals in it, besides five of us. We had a real live spider, a tarantula, and we had a real live woman.
America, this is Mariah.
Hello.
And she's here to choke me out. And she played kind of like this femme fatale.
She did a lot of cool stuff to you.
She choked me out.
Tied you up.
She tied me up and dragged me across the floor.
There was a brief straddling moment too, kind of right before the choking.
Awkward.
Awkward.
See, because we had just met each other, and it was that scene, and it was really weird. But I was trying to act like I was cool with it. I'm like, hey, I'm in a rock band, we do this all the time. But we don't.
So you remember before when I said that everyone was busting my chops about the model? They're doing the shot right now with Adam and her in bed together. And still haven't talked to her, and I'm not gonna, no matter what. Nothing's gonna make me talk to her.
Come to LA a lot. We could hang out sometime. Could be kind of fun.
She even came over to me at one point and I was just like...
No, it's not working.
Like a rock.
Hey guys, Ed Reyes here. I'm gonna do an interview. He's only the drummer, so it's really not that important. But his name is Mark O'Connell, and I'm just gonna have a couple words with him.
What's up, everybody?
Hey, Mark O'Connell, how's it going?
Just hanging out, just waiting for my cue.
You've been sitting around all day, so I mean, does that mean you're kind of like not that important that you've just been sitting around all day?
Right.
Right.
That's okay. Right.
Hey, Mark, what do you call the guy that hangs out with the band?
The drummer, dog.
That was my day right there.
I actually waited 11 hours to do that.
I always remember my favorite thing growing up listening to different bands was that I would just take the song and relate it to my own life and make it mine. So that's what I hope everybody does with this one. Because maybe you know somebody, you know, who's not always so honest. Or maybe you're not always so honest. Or maybe you know somebody who knows somebody else that's not always so honest.
Like the most professional spider in Los Angeles. He's like the sickest spider actor there is. I even heard he's dating Scarlett Johansson. Look at him, he's so pro. He just so in the moment, pouring emotion out.
Performing in front of the green screen, it's one of the oddest experiences.
It's a lot like singing to your mirror in your bedroom, but that everybody's watching you.
It's exactly like that. A long night spent with your most obvious weakness.
You start shaking at the thigh. You can picture all kinds of different things happening while you're performing because there's nothing there. It's just you and then like two dozen people watching you. So to make myself more comfortable, I would picture 20 or 30 unicorns like galloping behind me on the green screen, and that's what it would sort of look like. That put me at ease.
The coolest thing about green screen is that it kind of makes it possible to go anywhere. For instance, I could be at the beach, hanging out, soaking up the sun, checking out the ladies. Hey, ladies. Or, say I wanted to be, you know, in Alaska. Brr, it's cold in Alaska. That's right. Or even, you know, maybe I just want to be back in the green room where it's green. Or maybe I want to be in the room standing next to myself. Hello, me.
Hello, me.
So all in all, green screen, good time.
There's a part where we're pretending to be in a spider web and we're trying to shake loose, and none of us really knew how to act like we were in a spider web. But
it's never happened to any of us, to my knowledge.
Well, there was that one time Mark fell.
That wasn't a spider web, though. That was a big pile of garbage.
But it could, I mean, I'm saying like metaphorically.
Definitely.
That's a wrap. We hope you guys enjoy the video.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are Taking Back Sunday, and this is our video for our song, Liar. It takes one to know one on MTV2.
Yeah.
Bah! Get away from Oprah!